Assessing the value of an NFT might seem like a challenging task today, but certain methods are tried and tested in this industry. These methods are more like indicators towards profitable NFTs. Note that when I use the word indicators, I am not referring to the simple or generic ones. I am not going to talk about brands or artists or even the age of the NFTs. I want to help you in your NFT journey the right way, so I have decided to make this video on the more advanced factors that can help you with your research. I am going to start with the four pillars of NFT value. These pillars are considered to be the strongest indicators of a valuable NFT. They have also been backed by all the leading NFT experts, so make sure that you pay close attention to them. The first pillar is the ownership history of the NFT. I know this one sounds obvious, but it is more detailed than you would imagine. Value depends on the identity of the initial issuer or the previous owners of the NFT. An NFT with a high ownership history value can fetch the same prices as the ones made by famous artists, global celebrities, or brands. This way, you do not need to look for popular artists or creators, but rather, you should look at the people who have owned the NFT. For example, suppose an NFT is made by an unknown artist, but is then sold to a scientist. Even though this scientist might not be popular, the NFT will still fetch a higher price in the secondary market. This is because being a scientist is a unique profession and it is attractive to buyers who prefer to buy from a respectable owner. It also adds to the historic value of the NFT because NFTs are not that old to begin with. This way, even a $500 NFT can fetch much higher resale prices that can go up to $4,000 or $5,000. Judging value can be very difficult if you are only looking at ownership history. Another factor to consider is artist potential. For example, suppose an upcoming artist purchases an NFT. Now, this person might not be popular today, but your research suggests that they are going to become very successful within the next year. You can take the risk and purchase this NFT right now for probably $200 or $300. When the artist becomes a massive superstar within a year or so, then you can sell the same NFT for maybe $100,000. Of course, you will need to conduct strict and authentic research for this to work out. The next pillar is rarity. Rarity is inherent within NFTs as they are by nature unique. What matters most importantly is that some are more unique than others. If you can capitalize on the rarity factor of an NFT, then you are looking at a gold mine. Let me give you a situation to explain this better. Suppose an NFT collection has around 100 totally unique characters. Some of these characters will have different traits, features, or visuals that make them rarer than others from the very same collection. These rarities will drive a massive increase in value. This pillar has been driven by the success of the CryptoPunks NFT collection. Now, even cheaper NFT collections like NBA Top Shots have high-value NFTs because of their unique NFTs. So when you are looking for a profitable NFT, make sure that they have features or characteristics that no other NFT possesses. It might sound easy, but you will be surprised to see how common some features are. This is because of Bored Ape's Yacht Collection. The massive success it received has led to many artists copying features that were rare before. You need to search for rarity values of certain features, and only then can you go ahead and look for NFTs with those features. The third pillar is utility. Utility is one of the most frequently discussed topics within the wider crypto and NFT space. It also has a lot more to do than just adding to the current value of the NFT. Experts have discovered some really interesting applications of NFTs recently, thanks to their utility. More specifically, in the last 6 months, programmers have been enhancing their video games by adding scarcity to in-game items or power-ups. Basically, they keep adding more items to their in-game NFT tokens. For example, when an NFT game character is made, the creators add more features like a unique shield, armor, or an extra weapon. When a character has added utility, it automatically increases in value because of the advantages it provides to the players. The other kind of utility that NFTs offer is bearing yields. This gives them value beyond a simple resale. Owning an asset that provides returns will create a higher demand for that asset, and will ultimately demand a higher price. When the yield has a direct impact on the game, the asset's value will rise even higher. This is because it inserts user interaction and attention into the asset. I'm going to explain this better with an example. Suppose you are playing Axie Infinity and you find a recovery armor that costs $800. The purpose of this armor is not just to protect your character, but also to restore health from any earlier damages. Since it is a yield-bearing asset, you can purchase it and add it to your character. The value of your character will increase greatly after that. It is even better if you complete the game with this character. NFT characters that have won or completed games are also highly profitable because the playing history is transparent. So keep your eyes out for any NFTs that have high utility. The fourth and final pillar is liquidity. High liquidity means a higher value NFT. This is like a golden rule of NFT trading. NFT tokens that are made on the Ethereum blockchain have a higher liquidity premium than those made on other platforms. This is because Ethereum standard NFTs can be exchanged easily across secondary markets. All you need to do is purchase the NFT with the Ethereum cryptocurrency. However, there's a catch. If the market for your specific NFT collection is not very active, then you might run into some liquidity problems. In other words, if no one wants to buy your asset, you cannot sell it. Even if you do, it will not be for the price that you want. Investors prefer to put their money into NFT assets that have a high trading volume because they have higher liquidity by default. Platforms such as OpenSea are filled with liquid NFTs, so you can start here. However, you need to mix all the four pillars together into your research. This will allow you to select the best NFTs from what is available on the marketplace. Now, I am going to talk about some other factors that will help you in your search for profitable NFTs. These might not be as effective as the four pillars, but they can still be useful to your research. First is security. It is important to NFT buyers that their NFT's blockchain stays secure. This might sound silly considering that Ethereum is such a secure blockchain platform. However, security also includes whether the NFT is on-chain or off-chain. This involves the NFT's metadata. On-chain means the direct inclusion of the metadata into the smart contract representing the NFTs. Off-chain representation means hosting the metadata separately due to storage limitations of the Ethereum blockchain. On-chain metadata makes an NFT more valuable. This is because the metadata is already incorporated into the token. It allows the NFT to last forever or as long as Ethereum exists. Also, on-chain tokens have to meet certain Ethereum standards. This gives them a liquidity premium and makes trading easier. On-chain NFTs are usually hosted on Ethereum blockchains, but you must check the token ID to verify whether the metadata is also incorporated. Try to avoid off-chain NFTs. Second, you should also look at the release pace of NFTs. In other words, you must check the quantity of the NFTs. If the creator has minted 1,000 copies of the same NFT, then you might not gain a higher price for it in the future. However, if the NFT only has 100 copies, then there's a chance that it will sell for a much higher price in the future. This is a great way to look for NFTs made by smaller artists. If these artists don't drop many copies of their NFTs, then they are bound to become popular because experts discuss such artists quite often. Third, NFTs that also come with physical copies are considered to be of much higher value upon resale. For example, if you purchase an NFT of a digital painting that also comes with a physical painting, then you have great potential. You might find a buyer who is willing to pay an extra premium on a physical asset. You can use this to your advantage and demand a much higher rate simply because of this. You might even end up selling the physical item for more than what you paid for both. Lastly, there's a new trend emerging where artists destroy all other copies of their NFTs. This means that the NFT that has been put up for sale is the only piece that exists in the world. However, we have seen cases where the artist's representatives and estate have prevented them from doing such things. The most popular example of this was a Basquiat NFT. More recently, the Charlie Bit My Finger YouTube video was sold off as an NFT. The owner of the video promised to take it down from YouTube once the NFT was sold. YouTube has not yet taken the clip down, but the video now has a text added to its title. It reads, "Waiting on NFT decision." These are high-profile examples, but you can find lower-priced NFT collections where artists are promising to destroy all other copies if they find a buyer. This kind of exclusive art will have a strong rarity value, and can fetch a multiple even as high as 10 times the original price. Please remember that this method is not as popular as any of the other factors that I have mentioned earlier, so only use this in your research if you want to take a calculated risk. A few online tools can help you out with identifying high potential NFTs. However, I will not be covering them in this video as it will become too lengthy for you. You can find it later on my channel, so be sure to subscribe and check it out. If you want to learn about undervalued NFTs, then click the link in the description. I hope to see you soon. Goodbye.